Now that you've got the report writer open, let's go ahead and talk about the rows. Now, regardless of whether it's accounts or dimensions that power the report, you're going to see a pretty similar screen here. You're going to have a row structure column, a detail level column, a basis for amounts column, and an always display column. Other than the basis for amounts, you can always click on the question mark to get a new description of what that column is, how it works. But as a generality, you're going to find that each of these rows reflects an individual row within a report. And you can see that by looking at your live preview. So we'll go ahead and take a look at the preview for this report. We'll see that each of these rows represents one of the account groups or one of the accounts within an account group for what we saw on the previous screen. So if we take a look at, say, assets, current assets, cash and cash equivalents, and general checking, we can find that general checking must be an account within the cash and cash equivalents account group. If we wanted that to, instead of showing each of the individual accounts, we could summarize that and say hide accounts. If we reload that, we'll see that cash and cash equivalents is now just a summary line. You could expand it in the live preview back to the general checking and petty cash accounts. However, if you had printed this out, it would always be cash and cash equivalents. So whether you've got that in PDF or Excel format, if it defaults to unexpanded or summarized, then it will be summarized in that printout. When you're on a summary line, you also have the option to expand by dimension. So, for instance, we could take a look at the cash and cash equivalents summary per department. There's several different levels of this, but as a generality, you'll have one level down with roll-up, all levels with roll-up, or all levels with individual balance as the most important to pay attention to. If you're going to use one of these, the roll-up is going to give you values that don't have a department, and the individual balance will not. So if we take a look at individual balance, we can see that construction operations is the only one that has an amount shown here. And if we instead take a look at all levels with roll-up, and let that load up, we can see that there's an additional almost $200,000 that's not assigned to any particular department. When you look at your basis for amounts, you can have that pick from the group, or you can set it for the current period, from the start of the period, or at the end of the period, so you can get the amount over the given period, the amount at the beginning of the period, or the amount at the end date of the period. You can also use a cumulative balance or have it display as the percentage of another account group or account. Always display determines whether or not the amount will show up if it's a zero. So if we go ahead and say always display, we can see that all of our departments show up even if they have a zero value.